Speech is the most important of the acoustic signals. To understand how a patient perceives the speech, it is necessary to use the speech stimuli, and the testing method is called speech audiometry. In speech audiometry, the patient is presented with a succession of standardized speech stimuli, typically one-syllable words or phrases designed to assess certain aspects of the patient's hearing ability. During this video, we will have a look at how simple it is to carry out speech audiometry using the Harp audiometer. To run a speech audiometry test, the related window must be opened from the main menu by rotating the left knob. Select the speech audiometry test and press the left interrupter or the OK navigation button to confirm the selection. The red and blue buttons correspond to the selection of the ear to be tested. Press both at the same time to perform a bilateral test. Transducer selection is made by pressing the output key. The speech signal can be presented to the patient through headphones, bone vibrator, or loudspeakers. The input buttons are used to select the input signal. The input signal for speech audiometry can be a microphone for live speech connected to the mic or talk over input on the rear panel, depending on the setup. An external audio source connected to the external 1 and external 2 inputs, or, only for the plus model, the internal flash memory on which the speech material is already stored. In the case of internally stored material, playback can be started by pressing the play pause button in the upper left corner of the keyboard. Before starting a speech audiometry test, the gain level on the selected input must be adjusted to ensure that recorded speech material utilized for the test, or the operator voice, in the case of live speech test, is played back at the correct volume. To start the reproduction of the speech material, press the gain key and make the necessary adjustment using the two knobs according to the selected speech input. Ideally, the VU meter will reach the zero value. Harp audiometer can perform four different speech tests. It is possible to measure the standard WRS graph, or, alternatively, the SRT, MCL, and UCL thresholds. If the option WRS single point has been enabled from the setting menu, the word recognition score is calculated as a single point instead of using a graph. Use the function button F3 below the screen to change the current test. A masking signal can be used to avoid the possibility of cross-hearing induced measurement errors. The masking signal is generated through the contralateral channel of the audiometer. Select the speech noise, or the white noise, or a signal incorporated into the audio track of the selected speech material. If the input selected for channel 1 is the internal flash memory, the following information will also be displayed: currently selected speech material, number of the current list, the last word presented to the patient, a symbol indicating the status of the player, play, pause, or stop. To start the test, it is necessary to make sure that the norm on is activated. The responses given by the patient are saved by pressing the two frequency selection buttons, which are also labeled correct and incorrect. The store button allows you to save the result. The function key F2, reset score, below the display resets the correct or incorrect answer counters and the percentage when needed. If the audiometer is equipped with the thermal printer, the print button starts printing the current test. Harp audiometers can be interfaced with a computer via a USB connection. The live view function allows viewing the pure tone audiometry to be carried out on the harp on the computer screen and to transfer the completed PTA to the Maestro software by simply pressing the 2PC button from the harp keyboard. Maestro must be previously installed on the computer with or without a proprietary database or as NOAA module. Let's now talk about another speech test that is optionally available on the Harp Plus, the QuickSyn. The measurement of SNR loss is important because understanding speech through noise cannot be reliably predicted from the pure tone audiogram. The QuickSyn test is therefore used to quickly measure signal-to-noise ratio loss by presenting 6 sentences with 5 keywords per sentence, recorded in 4 talker bubbles with decreasing SNR from 25 to 0. The speech material is loaded into the flash memory of the harp and can be selected by pressing the Material Function button. The test is started by pressing the play button located at the top left of the keyboard. During the test, it's possible to jump back and forth among the sentences on the list by pressing the previous and next buttons. Each sentence is presented at pre-recorded signal-to-noise ratios, which decrease in 5 decibel steps from 25, very easy, to 0, extremely difficult. At the end of each sentence, it is possible to assign the score of the sentence. To increase the score, the correct button should be pressed. The incorrect key is used to decrease the score. After all 6 sentences are scored, SNR loss can be estimated and saved using the store button.